right, so there you just heard the president of Egypt, at least according to that translation, I did not hear him utter the words that I am stepping down. I don't know why these crowds seem to be very exuberant, because it would seem to be disappointing. He seemed to be suggesting he was staying in business, at least for the time being. He spoke about the scheduled elections. But Fred Pleitgen, you're there at the, you're on the scene at Tahrir Square. What do the folks there think he said? Fred Pleitgen, I don't know if you can hear me, but what's the reaction there? Because it didn't sound to me, at least according to our translation.
I can't hear you. Yes, listen, they're very, very angry, these people. They're screaming, leave, leave. Right now, they're not obviously very happy at all. So were you able to listen to the speech?
Yes, of course.
What do you think now?
I think this guy, he doesn't want to leave it in peace. He doesn't want to leave the country in one piece. He just want to tear it apart before he leaves. I don't know if he has a brain or he has his brain somewhere elsewhere. He's saying that he wants to keep the country in one piece, and he wants to keep the country safe and dignity and this blah, 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 blah. For the last 30 years, he is trying to keep what he's keeping. It doesn't keep anything. He just talking in from a different island. He's ruling another country.
But you also heard he did not step down. He just did not say that he was.
No. He didn't step down. He just said that he is commissioning his vice president of all his rights and of all his actions, what he can do, what he can do. But in the Egyptian, the old Egyptian constitution that they are discussing now, the vice president, he is commissioned to do everything except three things: dismissing the parliament, dismissing the government, dismissing the constitution, or breaking the constitution to parts. Okay, what is he commissioning the vice president of? We can't do anything without his ass in the country.
So you're very angry now, I assume.
Of course we are. We all are. He's saying that. He's saying that some of the people of the Egyptian, and most of them, they're supporting him. They are not. Today, the physicians, the doctors, they all were here. The lawyers, they all were here. The actors, they all were here. Protestation is everywhere in the country. Everywhere in all the governments, they are all there. I don't know what he's staying for.
I am coming from outside Egypt. I came here direct from airport to Tahrir Square.
You came from outside Egypt? Where did you come from?
From Gulf. From KSA.
Okay.
From Gulf.
Saudi Arabia.
From Saudi Arabia. I came today only. I came to Tahrir Square. I will not leave here until he go. Or otherwise, we will kick his ass there.
Okay. What do you think will happen? Will there be more rage? Will people protest more? Will there be?
We are not leaving the place. This guy is calling for more rage in the country. This guy is calling for more rage in the country. Those people, they don't leave. They don't want to leave. We don't want him in the country. He is saying that he is our president and he led our first airstrike in October.
There's more time to go with his crimes. That's all.
And in the war of October, he didn't. Oh, in the panorama, October, in the Salah Nasser Street, you can go there. You can take your camera and go there. President Sadat and
Andre,
all the defense guys, they were there inside. He didn't lead the first strike.
Okay. As you can see, Wolf, people here absolutely enraged by the speech that they just heard, saying they feel Hosni Mubarak is absolutely out of touch with reality, and that they will not leave until he steps down. And I can tell you, tomorrow is Friday, which is usually a day of massive protests, and I think that's exactly what's going to happen, Wolf.
Yeah, we did hear, at least according to our translation, Fred, we did hear President Mubarak say he would delegate some powers to the Vice President Omar Suleiman, but we did not hear, at least according to our translation, the President of Egypt saying he was stepping down. If anything, he seemed to be suggesting he was going to stay in business at least until the September elections. He had all sorts of formulas for making sure they would be free and fair elections. Let's bring in Ben Wiedemann. Ben, I don't know if you were listening to the speech in the original Arabic or in English, but what's your sense? Because I didn't hear, at least according to our translation, Hosni Mubarak say he was leaving.
No, he didn't say that, Wolf. He said that he had delegated some of the presidential powers to the vice president, Omar Suleiman. But let's keep in mind that it was only the 29th of January when he appointed Suleiman is the vice president. Therefore, naturally, he will have some of those powers. What we heard was a president speaking in the first person as the president, saying, I will do this, I will do that, I will form committees, I have instructed. There was no hint whatsoever in that speech that he has in any way decided to relinquish most of his powers as the president. And that would explain why you're hearing this incredible uproar down in the square. Clearly, he came nowhere near Wolf to satisfying the demands of the people. If anything, he's just enraged them even more.
Yeah, well, let me bring Anderson Cooper in. Anderson, you were listening together with all of us, all of our viewers around the world, that we were told he was going to say, you know what, I'm stepping down. He did not say that. He didn't even seem to come close other than saying he was going to give some new powers to the vice president, Omar Suleiman. Is that what you heard as well, Anderson?
What we heard were the same lies that we've heard from him and his regime for more than 2 weeks now. What we heard is a man who clearly believes that he is Egypt. I was taking notes during what he said. He kept repeating this lie that this is all some sort of foreign interference, that these protesters are somehow, and that's something we've heard on state television, that they're being paid, that they're being motivated to go there. They're being paid $100 or 100 euros, depending on what report you hear. He talked about that they will not accept to listen to any foreign interventions and dictations, trying to play up on Egyptian national pride, saying that they're resisting the United States and others from who want to dictate to Egypt what they want. Again, these are lies of a regime who's trying to stay in power. He says it's not about me, Hosni Mubarak. It's about the people of Egypt. What you are looking at are the people of Egypt. It is all about Hosni Mubarak, and he believes it is all about him. He believes he is Egypt. He continues to talk about getting out of a crisis. He believes what you are seeing is a crisis. That is not the crisis. The crisis is what his government has done to try to attack those peaceful demonstrators, shutting down the banks, shutting down the internet service, shutting down the trains, attacking them first with billy clubs and sticks from his riot policemen, and then when that didn't work, switching to thugs, pro-government thugs. He keeps talking about, you know, playing up that we are not servants to anyone. We will not take dictation. I've never succumbed to international pressure, he said. He said, I live for this homeland. I will not leave. We will always be dignified. And he went on to repeat these lies about that a national dialogue, that he's undertaken a national dialogue, and that they have now committees working on how to amend the Constitution. This is a Constitution which has allowed emergency powers to stay in place for 30 years. These protesters are saying the Constitution is not valid. The Constitution is a Constitution which has allowed a dictatorship to reign unchecked. It's not about making a few amendments here and there. It's about fundamentally rewriting the Constitution. It's about fundamentally changing the regime. He talks about that they've appointed committees to look at constitutional changes and another committee to look at how to implement those constitutional changes. Well, we know who's on those committees. Those are judicial figures and dignitaries aligned with the Mubarak regime. These are cronies of Hosni Mubarak. These are not people. This is not a broad cross-section. One of the things the Obama administration is continuing to push for is a greater representation in the people that they are talking to. They haven't talked to Mohammed El-Baradei. They haven't talked to a number of the young people who are really behind these demonstrations. They've talked to a few people, but they really haven't reached out to try to get a broad cross-section of people, the kind of broad cross-section of people that will be necessary in order to actually get real democratic institutions. The reason those people are mad, and it maybe sounds like they're waving flags and it sounds like they're cheering, they are furious. I mean, this is a slap in the face. This is stepping on the grave, on the blood of the Egyptian people that has been spilled for more than 2 weeks now in that square that we're looking at, Wolf.
Anderson, we've gone back now to the translation, the Arabic translation. Our experts are Arabic speakers. And when he said he was going to transfer some powers, it was precise. He didn't say he was transferring powers to the vice president. He was transferring, quote, some of the powers to the vice president.
It's all lies.
Suggesting he's staying in power. He's not transferring all power to the vice president. He's saying he's transferring some of the power. So he's clearly sees himself, Anderson, as you correctly point out, as the president of Egypt. He's not going anywhere. He's staying where he is. And as we anticipated, this crowd, the thousands, the hundreds of thousands who have gathered at Tahrir Square, they're exploding in anger right now. We should not be surprised, especially because they were tasting Mubarak going down. They thought for the last 5 or 6 hours he was leaving. He is not leaving. He's creating committees. He's transferring some of the powers to his vice president, his handpicked Vice President Omar Suleiman, but he did not utter the words that he's leaving, he's stepping down. He sees himself as the president of Egypt. He's staying in power right now.
Wolf, he continues to paint himself as the bulwark of stability. What he has done for 30 years and what he continues to do now is try to make it a choice of two options, either Mubarak or chaos. He continually, in this speech tonight, said, the change we have started will not be retracted. We're going through difficult times. We cannot do anything to damage our economy. He continually talked about getting out of the crisis and restoring the economy, have safety for people so they can get on with their lives. What has damaged the economy, though, is the Mubarak regime's attempt to isolate and kill these protesters. I mean, it is the Mubarak regime, again, who shut down the internet, who shut down the train service, who have closed the banks. Those things didn't have to happen. They were trying to manipulate and create a crisis so that Egyptians who were on the fence, who weren't in the square, would say, oh my gosh, the only choice is between Mubarak and stability or these protesters in the square who are causing all this chaos. Again, the chaos has been caused by the Mubarak regime. These are lies which this regime continues to try to sell, not only to the people of Egypt, but to the world.
And it was only a few moments ago before the speech, the crowd was singing, they were dancing, they were very happy. This crowd right now, as our viewers around the world can see, they are not happy right now. Let's bring in Hala Gharani. She was just in Egypt last week. Hala, you speak Arabic as well, so you understand that Mubarak was very precise in saying he's not stepping down. He's merely handing over some responsibilities to his own handpicked Vice President Omar Suleiman.
It's just saying publicly what's really been the case at the top levels of this regime now since the Vice President was actually nominated to his post. Effectively and de facto, within this regime, Omar Suleiman has been holding the meetings, has been negotiating with some of the opposition members. So he's held that role, really, of the top executive decision maker for the last several weeks. So that's nothing new. There is a lot of disappointment coming from Tahrir Square. Many observers are saying this is really what 30 years as a dictator, as an autocrat, will do to a person completely out of touch with the will of the street in Cairo and in other big cities across Egypt. Ivan Watson is overlooking Tahrir Square. These pictures we're looking at, this live video feed, Ivan, shows people extremely disappointed and some very angry.
Hala, I'm watching hundreds of people leaving Tahrir Square and they're chanting, "The blood of the martyrs, we're going to the presidential palace. We're going to the presidential palace." Just minutes after Hosni Mubarak concluded his speech, during which the crowd was chanting at points, "Leave, leave," or "He leaves, then we leave." The suggestion that this crowd is going to try to, or at least part of it, try to move to the presidential palace, which is quite a distance from here, if they do in fact try to do that, that is going to ratchet up tensions in the capital, because that is far beyond the confines of Tahrir Square. There are a number of military checkpoints between here and the presidential palace. There's been talk about that in past days. If they do in fact try to do that, you could have potentially a standoff between the police at those checkpoints and hundreds, if not thousands, of angry demonstrators. So we're going to watch that very closely to see whether or not an actual push does take place. We do know that 2 nights ago, a group of demonstrators broke out of Tahrir Square and they advanced on Parliament and occupied that street in front of the gates of Parliament. They've been conducting 2 nights of a sit-in there, and they've said to us that they're going to continue ratcheting up the pressure. Hosni Mubarak has said he's not stepping down, and he has, and now it's up to the demonstrators in some way to respond. So we're going to have to keep a very close eye on this if they are in fact going to try to push.
How many people are we
through barricades.
Ivan, how many people are we talking about here in terms of the number that's peeled off to go to the presidential palace? Because this is 5 or 6 miles away from Tahrir Square, as opposed to the parliament, which is much closer. How many people did you see peel off from the main crowd?
I probably saw about 500-600 people marching through the crowd here, and there seemed to be funneling out past the Egyptian Museum right now. It is not by far. There does seem to be another column of people pushing through as well. And the only way to really keep an eye on this is probably to step out of the square to see where people are going to go right now.